Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and a retirement worth having without being monkeyed with too badly by the community, by strangers, or people who really have no true rights to your life. The hard part about right to life as a concept is we often and too often place it just in the hands of fetuses, the unborn, the people that haven't been brought into being yet. The true concept of right to life is allowing every human being to have a right to their own life underneath the Human Rights Declaration, which I talk about probably ad nauseum, but I don't care because I want you to know what your rights are in life. If your father and mother or your significant others in your parentage did not help you to know what your rights are in the world and did not teach you where your rights and personal boundaries begin and end, that's really on them. As you produce yourself into adulthood, now it's your responsibility to recognize the international treaties of our land. As a citizen of the United States, presuming those are the ones who are listening to this, you must understand what your responsibilities are in the world. I highly encourage you to go out to those websites that are produced for our nation that communicate what your rights are in this world and what your rights would be if you traveled abroad. As an international citizen and a foreign representative of our land, in life, we also have the U.S. Constitution, which surprisingly seems a one-page document these days, but it might have just been reduced down to microscopic ways. What I'm telling you is that we have rights that are federally protected. That is the next stage of our rights and responsibilities in America. Beyond that, we have the amendments that came about because there were certain things that weren't really well defined in our Constitution and under certain federal laws. We have a lot of other federal laws that protect a lot of things about our life. The life stages of our life, which is our right to life. The life stages of our life begin with our birth certificate, which is totally protected by federal law, saying it belongs to the individual, not to some mother of the individual, not to some father of the individual, not to some sibling, not to some cousin, and not to some total stranger. This is the most important document of our life. The challenge we have as American citizens is that they look like all different things and they are created in all different ways across America by different states that validate where we were born. Those states have a lot of laws that govern what we can and can't do with that certificate in terms of who we are and what we can do. But what I'm saying to you is the right to life is that right given by God under one God indivisible with regard to our national treasury that says we have the right to pursue life, liberty, and happiness in American culture, American society, and American relationships, which frankly are with other people. Beyond that, we have other legal documents of our life, our schooling, our education, our transcripts, our GPA, and all those things that mean something in the initial stages of building a career set, a career life. It is a part of our right to life and to pursue happiness and to pursue employment and to do that without any mobility impediment by any other human being in the world. It is true that people can go from poverty to success overnight, in theory. The overnight might be a year, the overnight might be 5 years, the overnight may actually be 10 years, like it is for a lot of actors in Hollywood, that they had to stick it out for 10 years before they really could shine because it took them that long to master the trade to get the right opportunities in life. And let's face it, some actresses and actors just don't choose the right movies for their career life. But some of them do, and some of them then walk away from Hollywood and do a hell of a lot else in their life. We've seen that with television series. We've also seen some actresses that never die. Some actors that can always reproduce their life, like William Shatner, which is an amazing guy. But the truth is, in life, we have moments of time to be real. And our lives don't really end up in Hollywood, do they? They end up on our life. The branding images, the branding capabilities, the branding strategies of our life. Our personal brand is what we call it in the marketing world. But our professional brand is how we market ourselves online and offline. What I'm talking about is our right to life. And our right to life says that these legal documents represent our life. Once we get married or we do something that creates a significant other or a partner, that's another document that is ours to manage in life. Our medical records and our financial records, our legacy records, like our life insurance policies, those are other legal documents that belong solely to the individual. Solely to the individual and somewhat a little bit to the heirs that then receive or benefit from those documents. But in life, we are responsible only to the Lord. It is not true. We are responsible to the significant others, the strategic partners, and the financial partners of our life. Those may be people that we are doing business with, or they may be people that we are employed with, and those are truths about legalities of our life. Every industry, every profession, every job has laws that govern it. Federal laws, frankly, sometimes state laws, occasionally local ordinances, but in truth, every law is trumped by the higher law, the higher organization, the larger structure, and frankly, the nation.